Hey guys, today I'm turning myself into this, a scarecrow, minus the black lips. So let's get started. Due Date is my must use product every time, all the time. I put this on my skin at night. I put this on my skin under makeup. I'm not gonna stop telling you guys that until you all have purchased it because you need it. Seriously, best thing you can do for your skin. So I'm putting that all over to start. And then I put what's left over on my hands. Now I'm going in with shade Olive One in the Botanical Foundation with a stippling brush, which provides lighter coverage, but still excellent coverage, as you are about to see. So I'm just going in and putting foundation all over the face to get started. I was a little nervous to do this look because I don't want to use my perfect eyeliner for all the black on my face, so I'm using a different one. I didn't know if it would work, but it did, because I don't want to waste my eyeliner, you know? Check out that coverage, by the way. And B, there was a winged liner in this situation, but y'all are about to see. Today is the first day that I have actually used our eyeliner to try to do a wing, because I usually think winged eyeliner looks ridiculous on me, but I actually love how it turned out. And you're about to see me get off the struggle bus for the winged liner, because this liner makes it so easy, but you'll see that in a minute. So anyway, I'm just putting a light spattering of foundation all over the face to begin. And you're gonna see me looking down a lot. I'm looking at the picture to make sure that I'm doing it right, you know, like looking at the inspo to make sure it isn't a fail. Now I'm going into the Modern Renaissance palette, into this orange shade called Real Gar, with a big fluffy brush, and I'm gonna make a mess on my eyelids. I'm just gonna get this everywhere. In hindsight, I know that this eyeshadow palette has fallout. I should have done my eyes first, but I didn't, so you'll see a little trick to clean all that up. But anyway, basically, I'm just putting this all over because it looks like she just has orange on and that's it. So I'm just like blending that out. And then I'm going to go in with a flat brush and put it on the actual eyelid to make it darker and all of that jazz here in just one moment. I'm notoriously messy with my eyeshadow because I don't have time to be super precise with it, and I know that I can go back and clean it up, so I just don't worry with it. You know what I'm saying? Because the cleanup is easy. It's not a big deal. And anyway, like I said, I'm just intensifying the orange color, same color, on my lid right now with a flat brush. And this is a synthetic brush from Urban Decay, the one good thing I got out of the palette that I got from them. I like some of their palettes, but most of them have way too much fallout for me to get on board with. So anyway, I'm just going to put this orange under my eye too to complete the crazy look. Look how much that orange makes my green eyes pop though. If you have green eyes, I challenge you to wear some orange eyeshadow. You'll be amazed at what it does for your eyes. So I'm going in with a blenderful now that's just dry, like it doesn't have any product on it, and I'm just cleaning up the eyeshadow, and then I'm going to reapply some foundation in those areas to fix that up. You know what I'm saying? Because it needs some help. Look at the coverage with the blenderful. If you want full coverage with the foundation, you need to use a blenderful or a beauty blender. You can get light coverage with a brush if that's what you're going for. You can get even lighter coverage if you use a brush and mix it with a little bit of the oil, which I do that sometimes too whenever I'm going for that BB cream look. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, that's not what we're going for today. So here we are. Now I'm going in with my eyeliner. This is just a NYX eyeliner, and I'm using it to do the drawing because, as I said, I don't want to use my perfect eyeliner pen, because now that I've discovered that I can actually do a wing, I want to save it for that. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just doing the stitching stuff with this eyeliner, and it ended up working pretty well. The eyeliner pen would have been more precise, but this didn't do a bad job, so I'm stoked. This is the eyeliner that I use for my waterline all the time, BT Dubs. It's the NYX eyeliner, and I think that they're the best for the waterline. Just FYI. So now, in hindsight, you know, hindsight is always 20/20. I should have drawn on my nose thing after I did the little color in the middle, but I like to do things the hard way. You know what I'm saying? I don't really like to do it the easy way, and I didn't think about it at all until after I'd got it all drawn, and I'm like, man, should have put the color in the center first, but whatever, I made it work. So, just drawing in the stitching on the nose. Next up, we're going to use some Peanut Butter Cup. Peanut Butter Cup is my current obsession for a fall liquid lipstick. It is awesome, but that's what I'm going to use today as the nose color and my cheek color. So I'm just putting just like a little bit in there. And this will also show you how you like, you can put it onto your lips. You have a little, you have just a little bit of time to work with this before it dries down and sets matte. And you can put just a little bit on your lips and then blend it out and you get like a lighter version of the color, which I mean, I know it's on my nose, but it's really, really pretty. The lighter version of the color. I really like that too. So now I'm going to put it on my cheeks using the same, the liquid lipstick, making some circles, and then I'm going to blend those out with my finger because this stuff is pigmented. So we'll blend out the circles. Oh, and this smells super good, by the way, if you were ever wondering about that. I didn't really try to make perfect circles because I think that looks a little crazy. And then I'm also going to go back in with that eyeshadow that we used over top of the blush, the lipstick that I'm using as blush, just to, because I wanted to make it a little bit more orange. Peanut Butter Cup is not really that orangey on its own, so I'm adding in some orange color. And also kind of diffusing the edges of the little circular blush thing that I just did. So there's that. That'll also set it, which, I mean, it would set anyway, but. And you guys, I didn't realize this. Okay, this is my favorite part. This is where you're going to see me to be able to do a wing so fast. I did not speed this part up. And I'm usually seriously on the struggle bus with a winged eyeliner. So I was freaking out about it. But our eyeliner pen makes it so easy. Seriously, it's so user-friendly. And you'll see how quick I did it in just a second. You're going to be impressed. I mean, I'm just telling you right now, you're going to be impressed. So I just go in, filled in the end there, and now I'm doing just a little flick. Watch for it. And I brought it up from, like, the bottom. Started from the bottom, now we're here. You know what I'm saying? Okay, so I do the little flick, and then I just go back in and fill it in, and it was so flipping easy. Like, I was so worried about this whole time, and it was, like, probably the easiest part. Check out that wing. Did you see me do my little happy dance? My little I have a wing happy dance? That's what I just did. Those wings are looking good. Anyway, I didn't realize this whole video that I had a hair stuck to the side of my face, so sorry about that. It's all up in my blush, but anyway, I didn't know where I would have moved it. So I'm just putting Peanut Butter Cup on my lips now to keep this look, you know, all one color. And then we're going to draw on the stitching back to my NYX eyeliner for that. And we're just going to add some little stitches to my face and my lips and whatever, to try to look like a scarecrow. That is the end game here. And this is the look that you guys have voted on, so that's what I did. I'm not a makeup artist. I am definitely not the best at Halloween looks. Like, I tend to stick to the easier ones, the ones that I feel like are going to be the most doable, because sometimes I think they're a little difficult, sometimes I think they're a little dramatic, you know. But this one turned out really pretty good, I thought. Adding in some freckles now. Now we're going to put on some Perfect mascara to get some lashes going with these wings. Again, I say, did y'all see how good the wing looks? I mean, seriously, I didn't even have to go in and clean it up or anything. That is the fastest and best wing I have ever done in my life. I'm not joking. I'm not exaggerating. If you've ever heard me talk about it, then you know that I'm normally on the struggle bus. But anyway, I'm not going to talk about it anymore. I think you guys get the point. But anyway, here we are putting on some mascara, and then we'll do my favorite part. We're going to give me some brows. I'm using the medium brow gel from Limelife by Alcon. Look, when that first little hint of brow hits, it like makes me happy all the way to my soul. Seriously, this brow gel is so user friendly, so easy to use, and it is so good. So good. Cannot emphasize that enough. If you take away two things from this video that you need in your life, Dew Date and brow gel should be on those lists. Seriously. I mean, I think you need it all, but that's just me. And I'm also a makeup junkie. So, anyway. Now we're going to do the other brow. Y'all, it makes such a difference. I really just, I don't think you can even tell so much on video or camera or whatever as you can tell in person, but it just makes such a huge difference and it's so easy. And the main thing that I love about it is there's no cleanup. Like, really, there's not. It just attaches to what brows you actually have. So, anyway, here's the final look, guys. What do you think? Did I nail it? I think I nailed it. Check it out.